Boy.
So, why was Tyr helping Odin meet with the Giant Kings?
Tyr was hopeful to convince all parties they would prosper best through peace. He knew the Giants were deeply concerned about the hammer, a super weapon in hands they did not trust. But they trusted Tyr. Tyr always believed the best in people, and taking Odin at his word in his desire for peace, he brought the Raven King to Jotunheim. From there, things unraveled quickly. The Giants anticipated Odin's trickery and exposed his true agenda to spy and steal their secret wisdom. With magics, they expelled Odin from their realm and cursed him never to return. Frustrated, Odin visited his fury upon the Giants of Midgard. Thor unleashed Mjolnir's might upon any giant he could find. None could stand against the tide of slaughter that followed. And at last, it seems, with Tyr's aid, they retreated. The tower disappeared, no giants could be found in Midgard, and no man nor god has set foot in Jotunheim since.
There sure is a lot to see here. Treasures from all different realms. Do you think that Fafnir went to Alfheim too?
I do not know.
Aren't you curious? He sounds interesting.
We go to the storeroom to collect anything useful for our journey, not to learn more about the dwarf.
Fafnir was a rather interesting fellow, little brother. Perhaps I'll tell you. Day.
Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
Reavers.
Uh-oh. They must have gotten here first.
Thank you.
hands.
Whoa.
Boy.
Yes, sir. It's another one of those maps. Looks like the Reavers made it inside. I hope they didn't take all the treasure. No magical treasure, and no whatstone.
Keep your expectations low, boy, and you will never be disappointed. They caught you off guard.
I wasn't expecting them.
Exactly. Resources. The main reason we are here, boy. However, many of these chests have been emptied.
Probably by the Reavers. I hope they didn't take Sindri's whetstone. good feeling about this next one. Maybe we'll even find the whetstone.
Remember what I told you about expectations, boy.
Keep them low. I remember. Still, good feeling.
Enemies ahead!
I was ready for them this time.
I saw.
So I should keep my expectations low, but always expect an attack?
It is a delicate balance. Expect the worst. Assume nothing, and always anticipate an attack.
Sure is a lot to remember. Whetstone. And only one room left. I know I shouldn't hope, but do you think we'll find it there?
No.
Back to piss on my corpse, you ungrateful little...
Who are you two?
We're looking for a whetstone. Have you seen it?
Aye, there was one in this room. My son sharpened his dagger on it, right before stabbing me in the back.
What?
Little bastard thought it was his turn to lead my crew. I was hard on him, sure. Guess I shouldn't be surprised. I did the same thing to my dad when I was his age.
He killed his own father?
Where is he now?
He may be a bastard, but he's my bastard. You'll get no help from me, fool.
Then his dagger will help.
Hey! That's mine! Harry!
Come, boy. We are leaving.
Choke on it!
Remember what I told you, boy. Assume nothing.
Well, sure. He didn't seem like a great father, but...
You only know half the story.
Yes.
Well, what did you think of Fafnir's store?
We found no whetstone. This dagger belongs to the Reaver who took it.
They took most of the good stuff.
Oh? Well, here, take this. In exchange for the dagger. The dagger you brought me is quite interesting, an artless design, but the construction is sound. Where in the temple did you find this?
In Ariver's back.
Oh. Oh.
He mentioned he was part of a larger clan. Maybe they took the whetstone?
Quite possibly. I know I've seen this design before. Don't forget! Don't wash your hands.
Like the heat, Brock.
Heat's damned useful in my line of work. Even makes space itself.
Come.
Okay. Wow. It's hot here. But is that snow?
Ash. It only falls like that for great fires.
The whole realm is a great fire. The source of fire itself. And all the sun and stars, if legend is to be believed.
Should we believe? I mean, we're here, and we're not on fire.
Not yet.
Well, you know, I suppose it's cooled considerably since the dawn of creation, hasn't it? Niflheim isn't exactly ice these days, either. It's in the nature of things. Extremes are tempered by time. Fires burn colder, men grow old and grey, heads are chopped off and attached to belts. Such is life.
Okay, Mimir.
Thank you.
Got another favor to ask you two.
What do you want, dwarf?
I got another lead on my old pal Anvari. Meet me at the Lawn Soother Mines. There's some fancy-dancy loot in it for you.
Another lead? But we already found him. Well, found his hand anyways.
I'll explain at the mines. These ones...
Niflheim. Not sure why anyone would want to come here, but here we are.
It smells bad.
Got you all bum-fuzzled over there. Get going!
Amir, why did you work for Odin if he's so horrible?
It's my career! And if you mean to make your career as a counselor to kings, you can't very well rule out petty maniacs. Available positions are scarce enough. My first master was a cool piece of work as well, but I learned through him the enduring power of wit, which served me well with kings and gods alike. I couldn't have been much older than you when I started. A fairy king's errand boy and unofficial jester. By night, my mates and I had the run of the forest. Good fellows, they called us. Knavish sprites to the last. We'd get up to all manner of mischief, making fools of the local mortals. But as long as our lord was kept amused, we were spared the consequences. Then one day he was not amused. And I saw fit to move on. Thankfully, the ages and roads traveled since then have turned me from that merry wanderer into the path. Paragon of virtue you see before you today. Thank you.
Well, looky who decided to show. Talk to this here ring.
What? I can't hear thoughts from rings, Brock. It's talking to me! It's Unvari!
Ha! Knew it.
He says he went to the Velander mines to observe his mistake. But then the Soul Eater attacked, so as he was being ripped apart, he cast a spell that removed his soul and put in this ring. And then he...
What about all his stuff? Unvari had a workshop here with all sorts of posh doodads and ornatory tools. And one beaut of a hammer. He make mention of it still in there?
You're upsetting him.
Your point? You fellas take Unvari with you and go have a look-see. If you find his hammer, I'll whip up something real nice for you. Hey now, don't go forgetting your entry stone.
Unvari isn't happy about us taking his stuff.
I do not care.
I'm not gonna tell him that. Unvari says this dwarf is part of his crew, that he died because of his mistakes. He sounds sad.
The ring's grief is of little importance, boy.
Did not like that. He's warning us not to go down there.
Stop listening to the ring, boy. Cannot be trusted.
Join us.
Silence that ring, boy.
I don't know how.
And a traveler. Guard up.
A dead Soul Eater. What's a Soul Eater even doing here? What do you mean it's your fault?
Boy, ignore him.
It's sort of tough for me to ignore.
Workshop is up there. But I know, don't trust the talking ring.
Father, please, just listen. Invari's crew did something bad here. He's glad you destroyed his life, and he's sorry he kept trying to trick us. His hammer is just through this gate.
This is a fine hammer.
Invari says thank you.
Boy.
Yes, sir. Wonder who wrote this.
We will talk to the blue one. Here, the alchemist's hammer. His spirit is a nuisance.
Yeah, Anvari always was an asshole. Hell of an alchemist, though. Hand him over here and I'll melt him down.
What? You're going to melt down your friend?
A trapped soul's what I need to give your reward some extra oomph. You don't want it?
Father, we can't do that. Here, you hold on to him. He's really useful, I promise.
Fine. So long as he proves his worth.
Kid's a bit of a softy, huh? Well, he'll grow out of it. Check back soon.
Amir, how'd you come to be in these lands?
Lad, there comes a time in every man's life when he changes his name and heads north to make a new start. If you live long enough to do this many times over, you might end up as far north as this place. By the time I arrived, I already knew Odin by his reputation, and so I set to demonstrate my worth by coming to him with something I knew he'd value, a mystic well of knowledge. Or rather, I should say, a well of water laced with enough mystic mushroom. Make a god see visions. Oh, he was rightly impressed. Can't say for sure what he saw that led him to try gouging out his own eyes, but I managed to restrain him before he finished the job. Then I persuaded him it has been his sacrifice made for an even higher form of sight to be bestowed. Blah, 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 blah. I used to think he never caught on. But the day he took my eye, I realized he had never been fooled. He knew I'd outwitted him, called the lesson wisdom, and hired me to make sure from then on I was on his side. And for a long, long time I truly was. Doesn't mean he didn't hold a grudge.
You want a beach here?
boy.
Treasure map. All right.
Whoa!